Hi there folks, in today's demonstration I'm going to map out a business process for onboarding new employees and then using various GPT tools such as 4 Omni and also Copilot, I'm going to demonstrate how you can build different process maps, entity diagrams and also create high level designs using prompts. So these are ideas for seasoned developers but also citizen developers in order to support you with the next development of your existing business processes. So I'm going to start things off from my whiteboard and I'm simply going to map out the process of onboarding new employees. So we have the manager persona. They're going to complete a form or a power app for that new employee, and then we can think about the different automations we might have. So first up, when that new employee is created, we might want to trigger a flow, and with that flow, we might just simply want to create a new item or a new record and potentially send an email to that manager. Off the back of that new record being created, we might trigger another flow. And with that flow, we might have a couple of different child flows, maybe several, depending on the different tasks we want to carry out, those tasks for IT, for HR, and indeed the manager. But then if we think about the data sources, we want to have potentially two different data sources, one for the employee, so for each of the employees they're recorded in a list or a table, and then those four tasks. How do these all relate? Well, as we create an item, they go into the list. As they go into the list, that'll trigger the second flow. And we mustn't forget that you complete the former app to create the new employee. We have those child flows that will write tasks to the task list. And then for each of those child flows, maybe we'll create tasks, or in fact, maybe we'll have a full automation and create a new AD user. Next up, for those that don't like drawing, we've got a tool called Diagram GPT, and with a simple prompt, you can generate a flowchart. So if I click on the Generate Diagram button, very quickly we'll have that flowchart or process map come together and hopefully offer you some inspiration. Now, if that's not enough, with a slightly modified prompt, I can generate some tables. And here we can see a sample couple of entities or tables based on the employee and tasks. Now, if I jump back to that original sketch that I did and I take a screenshot of that, I can jump over to chatgpt.com, paste that into what's now ChatGPT 4o Omni, and with a prompt, I can simply ask it to produce a high-level design. And we can see it describe the different components, the overview of the process, and then some detailed steps about each of these stages. It then moves on to the implementation steps, talks about creating the form, the Power Automate flow, and the different lists. And we also go into some of the details around the flows and the triggers for the child flows. Then I'm going to show a slightly different prompt that's going to use something called a mark map, and it will generate some markdown based on the content of what we've discussed. And with that markdown, I can simply highlight it, copy it, and paste it into this mark map. And you'll see that instantly I get a mind map with, again, all the different processes. So if you're someone that likes to look at things visually, you can see how you can use GPT to create a mind map. Now, this wouldn't be one of my videos without a Power Automate flow. So you'll see that I've built a cloud flow with a system prompt and a variable here with a message array that contains both the system and the user prompt. But ultimately what's going to happen is I'm going to call the REST API GPT-4o that's currently deployed and Azure, and then post the results of that high level design to a channel in Teams. So if I go and click on import and attach that original sketch that I did earlier, and if I paste in the details of this particular process and then run the flow, what's happening now is we're taking that image that I've attached, handing it to GPT-4o, passing in the description of the process and creating a high level design. And that high level design has now been posted into a channel and goes into the similar sort of detail that we saw earlier on chatgpt.com, albeit it is now a full blown automation and maybe even something that you could consider calling from a copilot so that people get consistent basic HLDs as a result of their sketches and their descriptions. Now, for completeness, I thought I'd try this out on Copilot. So if I drag across that sketch from earlier, use the same prompt, but specifically call out that I want to use my image to summarize this process, the response that we get back, whilst it gives us a high level design, it is very basic by comparison. So between GPT-4o and Copilot, which is currently GPT-4 Turbo, you can see there are some differences. There are some options, some of which are manual, but hopefully this gives you some ideas for the next process that you plan to build.